How to use Hive Project Management software. Hi there, today we'll learn about how to manage your projects using this Hive platform. Hive actually is a cloud-based project management and collaboration tools designed to help teams work together more efficiently. It offers features such as task management, project tracking, team collaboration, time tracking, and reporting. This platform actually aims to streamline workflows and improve team communication by bringing all aspects of project management into one centralized platform. So it integrates with various third-party tools such as Google Drive, Slack, Zoom, making it easy for teams to work with their existing workflows. And Hive is also used by businesses of all sizes across various industries, from startups to large enterprises. So for us to begin with, you can go to hive.com. And depending on what browser you have, you can go to hive.com and you will be routed into this page. So as you can see here, here are the products. They can project management, their goals, time tracking, a lot of information that you can take note of here that would definitely benefit business owners as well. So here you can sign up using your Microsoft Office account, or you can just use your Google account as well. So what we just need to do is that click on sign up with Google and then input your email address. And then you just need to allow and authorize Hive to access your Google account. Once you click on allow, it will load your Hive account and they will be asking a few informations later on that you need to fill out in order for Hive to know more about your business or about yourself. So first thing, they will ask your first and last name, your phone number, and they will be asking for you to create your own password for this account. Once done, you can go ahead and click on next. And when you click on next, you will be routed into this page where you need to name your own workspace. So you can have the team name. Once done, when you click on next, you will be asked for how many people would you be collaborating with your Hive account. And they will be asking as well about your goals for using this platform. So you're only able to choose one here. So once you have chosen one, you can go ahead and click on next. And then you will be inviting your team. So you have the emails that you may have here on your contacts, but you can go ahead and just use your email, and you can even enter other email address as well on the box below. And then you can go ahead and click on invite. Once you click on invite, they will ask you on what messaging platform you'll be using, whether you'll be using Hive's messaging platform, or you can also make use of your existing platform like Slack, Google Message, or Google Chat, MS Teams, anything. But for now, I'll just use Hive Messaging and then I'll click on finish. Just wait for it to load. And here it is. This will be your dashboard for your Hive account. This is where you mainly manage your project on the account here. So for us to begin with, we will be looking into the left side panel of the screen, where here you can see the Hive's logo. And on the three bars menu, you can actually hide and unhide these menus. So let's start with the home icon. That's your My Account. This is where you will be able to view the projects that you currently are working on your workspace. So here there are actually sample projects or sample tasks that Hive has made for us. And then you can go to apps. Here is your app library where you can actually use these applications to help you organize and collaborate as well with your team on working a project. So you can actually use a lot of applications here. So there are also a lot of existing applications that you may have, like Google Drive, Salesforce, Slack, and a lot more. Here are also some tools that you can use, like time tracking. You can also do the project linking, and that would actually depend on what type of project you are working on. So here on the next one will be Hive University. So these are actually courses that you can take or webinars that you can take to learn more about the skills that you can definitely hone with using the Hive platform. So going back to our workspace, after Hive University would be your goals. So it actually will provide you how much percentage have you done or completed with the project that you have on the account. And it also provides you the information like how to reduce customer churn on the account here for how much percentage that would be. So the next thing here is that we can create our project. So you can click on project that's below the goals menu. So here you'll be routed into your project navigator. You'll be able to see here that there are buttons that you can click to create a new project, or you can even add people to the projects that you have. So zooming in here, there are a lot of tabs that you can look into, like the active projects rather, your existing projects, your archived projects, the summary views, and even templates if you already have made some templates for your project. So here, let's start create a new project. I clicked on the new project here, and then you can either import a project or you can work with a blank project here. So here I picked a color for the project that we are, and we also will rename or name the project that we will be working on. So here, since this is just for an example, I'll just have this project for personal use, and I'll be choosing a layout as well. So I'd like how status view would look like, since I will be able to drag and drop the task that I'll be creating. So here, as you can see, the project that I've created is already added into the panel. And under the project, what we can do is we can list all the tasks that we will be working. And then let's say for unstarted, we can click on design project or design product rather, then project research. And if we are already working on a certain project, we can simply just drag and drop these tasks. And then once completed, we can simply drag and drop that as well. So if you want to add a new status, you can actually just click on the next panel here, and then you can just name this new status that you'll be adding. So I'll name it revisions. So for example, I will be revising design product. I can just drag and drop that here. So that's basically how you'll be creating your own project here in the Hive platform. So below these informations here, on the next step is that you can check on your My Teams. Under My Teams, this will be under Team View, or it's actually in each columns, there are your team members on the account. So for example, here, Hive has created a sample task. So for example, I wanna assign check out Hive Mastery. I'll be assigning that to Barb. And then if I will decide to let them take coffee break, I will just drag and drop that into the column of the certain team member. So I actually can look into different views here, like table view, calendar view. I can definitely change it. But since this is for my team, I'll just leave it as is. Here. So since we have the project, the next thing here is that on this part, it's actually the message box here where you can message everyone using these information. So you can just type in on the box here. This is where you can type in message. Like, for example, you will follow up your team on what you will need to do. And here as well, under direct message, you can actually chat or message, direct message each team member if you want to inform them personally of a certain project that they need to work on. So here we can even add a new message. For example, I only want to inform two of the team members that I want to inform with the same information. I can just click on that person and then I can add another person as well. And then we can start messaging. As you can see, we have two members and now it has been added here. So we can direct message to all-in-one information for KTPAD22 and also with Barb. So you can just close it. So this actually is a highlight that I can suggest with using Hive. Since aside from keeping track on the projects, you can simply message your team members directly using this application. So here on the upper right corner, you can see there's a plus icon where there's a new information. When you click that button, you can actually create new projects, new informations, new tasks that you can definitely add. And that's about it. That's how you will be using this platform to manage your project. And that's the end of the video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.